Hi friends, welcome you all to my YouTube channel EngLIT Zone. Friends, आज के अपने इस वीडियो में मैं English Literature के कुछ important questions discuss करूंगी. ये questions जो मैंने अपने इस वीडियो में include किया हुआ है, friends, ये बहुत ही important questions हैं और ये आपके previous exams में पूछे जा चुके हैं जो कि English Literature से related थे. चाहे वो आप NTA NET की बात करो, आप TGT से related exams, चाहे वो state level के हो या आपके central level के जो है TGT PGT के exams होते हैं, KVS NVS Army schools के and state level के जो आपके exams होते हैं. और most important ये NTA NET का exam जो होता है आपका, उसमें ये questions पूछे गए हैं आपके last year papers में जो आपके प्रीवियस एग्जाम्स हुए हैं इंग्लिश लिटरेचर से रिलेटेड. सो फ्रेंड्स, ये वीडियो मेरा फर्स्ट पार्ट है इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन से रिलेटेड. आगे मैं आने वाले वीडियोस में कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस और लेके आऊंगी. तो ये आपको ये वीडियोस इस पर्टिकुलर इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन से रिलेटेड 3-4 वीडियोस आपको मिलेंगे जो कि मैं 1 by 1 आपके लिए अपने चैनल पे मैं लेके आऊंगी. सो लेट्स बिगिन द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट 20 क्वेश्चंस ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर. Most important for your exams of English literature like TGT, PGT and NTA NET. So let's begin. Friends, question start करने से पहले मैं आपको सबसे important चीज़ ये बताना चाहूँगी कि जो भी questions मैंने अपने इस video में include किया है, whatever they are, I will explain important facts related to that questions also. Us questions ke jo important facts honge, it means on which year it was published, by whom it was written, I will explain also. Not only questions, and I will tell the answer also, and also the important facts related to that questions also. So आपको नोट डाउन अगर करना चाहो तो आप उसे नोट डाउन भी कर सकते हो, क्योंकि बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट इन्फॉर्मेशन मैं उन क्वेश्चन से रिलेटेड आपको इस वीडियो में प्रोवाइड करूंगी जो भी मैंने इस वीडियो में इंक्लूड किया हुआ है. सो द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस वीडियो इज हु रोट डॉन जॉन विच वॉज पब्लिश इन 1819. डॉन जॉन जो बुक थी वो 1819 में पब्लिश हुई है. एंड हु वॉज द राइटर ऑफ दिस बुक, दिस पोएम. Answer is Lord Byron. Lord Byron was the composer of this poem, Don Juan, and he himself called it a epic satire. Epic satire, इस poem को नाम दिया था Don Lord Byron ने. ये एक satiric poem थी, and it was based on a lover character whose name was Don Juan. एक lover character के ऊपर ये based on थी ये poem. Next question is who wrote the life of Johnson which was published in 1791. Answer is James Boswell. James Boswell was the writer of the book which was the biography of Dr. Samuel Johnson. Friend, the life of Johnson was the biography of Dr. Samuel Johnson. It was published in 1791 and it was written by James Boswell. Next question is in which poem does the following line occur? Our sweetest songs are those that tell of saddest thoughts. And it was, this line was written by P.B. Shelley. P.B. Shelley was the romantic poet and he was also known as the revolutionary poet. Revolutionary poet ke name se jaane jaate the P.B. Shelley. And from which poem it was taken? This line, this very famous line of English literature was taken from the poem Ode to Skylark which was published in 1820. Ode to Skylark जो poem थी वो P.B. Shelley के ने compose की है और ये poem 1820 में लिखी गई है. इस poem की सबसे important and famous line है Our sweetest songs are those that tell of saddest thoughts. So move on करते हैं अपने next question की ओर. Question number 4 is who is said to have the first used the term metaphysics? Answer is Dr. Johnson. Dr. Samuel Johnson was the first person to use the term metaphysics. Question number 5 is the writer of the line stone walls do not prison me. This was the line it was taken from the poem To Althea from Prison which was published in 1642. Mein ye poem published hui hai jiska title tha To Althea from Prison. And the most important and famous line of this poem was stone walls do not a prison make and it was composed by Richard Lovelace. Next question, question number 6 is Monkey's Paw which was published in 1902 is a, answer is supernatural short story which was कंपोज्ड बाय डब्ल्यू जैकब्स। एंड फ्रेंड्स ये जो बुक थी वो मंकीज पॉ का टाइटल नेम था एंड ये पब्लिश हुई है 1902 में। ये एक सुपर नेचुरल शॉर्ट स्टोरी पे बेस्ड ऑथ थी। क्वेश्चन नंबर 7 इज द राइटर ऑफ अ पेयर ऑफ ब्लू आईज व्हिच वाज पब्लिश इन 1873 इज, आंसर इज थॉमस हार्डी। ही वाज द वेसेक्स नॉवेलिस्ट इन इंग्लिश लिटरेचर। ही वाज नोन एज द वेसेक्स नॉवेलिस्ट एंड ही वाज फ्रॉम विक्टोरियन एरा और विक्टोरियन एज। विक्टोरियन एज से थॉमस हार्डी बिलोंग करते थे और उन्होंने अपनी नॉवेल जो ये लिखी है अ पेयर ऑफ ब्लू आईज ये 1873 में पब्लिश हुई है। फ्रेंड्स वेसेक्स वाज द प्लेस वाज द इमेजिनरी प्लेस व्हिच वाज इन द माइंड ऑफ द थॉमस हार्डी। लाइक आर के नारायणन वाज नोन हिज नॉवेल्स वर बेस्ड ऑन द मालगुड़ी डेज। मालगुड़ी वाज द इमेजिनरी प्लेस इन द माइंड ऑफ R.K. Narayanan in his novels. In the same way, Hardy's novel were known as the Wessex novel. He was known as the Wessex novelist in English literature. Friend, next question of the video is question number 8. Elizabeth Bennet is a character in, answer is Pride and Prejudice. This was the novel written by Jane Austen and it was published in 1813 mein ye novel publish hui hai, Jane Austen ne ise likhi hai and Elizabeth Bennet was the main character of the novel Pride and Prejudice. Friend, one thing we all know that Jane Austen's main theme of her novel were related to the domestic life. Her novels were called as the domestic novels. Jane Austen के novels जो थे वो domestic novels के name से जाने जाते थे। Pride and Prejudice, like Sense and Sensibility, Emma and Persuasions, these are the famous novels of Jane Austen. And Elizabeth Bennet was the chief character, main character of the novel Pride and Prejudice. Next question, question number 9. The Imp and the Peasant's Bride. This is a story by Leo Tolstoy. Leo Tolstoy is the answer of this question. And friend, Leo Tolstoy was the Russian writer and his most important novel was War and Peace. War and Peace he has written and this was the most important novel by Leo Tolstoy and he was the Russian writer. Russian writer the Leo Tolstoy. Next question. Question number 10. Magnus is a character in, answer is Apple Cart by G.B. Shaw. George Bernard Shaw was the writer of this novel Apple Cart and it was published in 1928. Next question ki taraf move on karte hain. Question number 11 is related to which poem starts with behold her singing in the field, answer is Solitary Reaper and it was composed by William Wordsworth. William Wordsworth ने ये poem composed की है The Solitary Reaper and ये 1807 में published हुई है and the line, opening line of this poem is Behold her single in the field. William Wordsworth जो कि one of the most important and famous poet हैं romantic age के and he has also written lyrical ballads with the collaboration or with the help of ST Coleridge also. ST Coleridge and William Wordsworth ne lyrical ballads likhi hai and it was published in 1798 and this poem Solitary Reaper was published in 1807. Next question is question number 12. Who wrote the poem Listeners and it was published in 1912 and the composer of this poem was Walter de la Mare. Walter de la Mare was the composer of this poem, Listeners. Question number 13 is, in which poem does the following line occur to strive, to see, to find and not to yield? This is the title, this is the very famous line of the poem, Ulysses. And it was composed by Alfred Lord Tennyson, one of the most romantic novelist, romantic poet. And it was published in 1842. And friend, Ulysses was also a novel by James Joyce. So, aap confused mat hoiyega bilkul. Agar kahi novel ki baat aati hai, to Ulysses James Joyce ne likhi hai. And agar aap
पोएम की एक बात आती है एंड दैट इज रिटन बाय कंपोज बाय एल्फ्रेड लॉर्ड टेनिसन. क्वेश्चन नंबर 14 इज द राइटर ऑफ द स्कारलेट लेटर. इट वॉज ए हिस्टोरिकल फिक्शन विच वॉज पब्लिश इन 1850 इज. इसमें राइटर का नाम पूछा जा रहा है स्कारलेट लेटर का, जो कि एक हिस्टोरिकल फिक्शन थी. एंड इट द राइटर ऑफ दिस नॉवल वॉज अमेरिकन ऑथर नेथेनियल हॉथॉर्न. नेथेनियल हॉथॉर्न वॉज द अमेरिकन राइटर हु हैड रिटन स्कारलेट लेटर विच वॉज अ हिस्टोरिकल फिक्शन एंड इट वॉज पब्लिश इन 1850. फ्रेंड्स, वीडियो को थोड़ा मैंने जल्दी इसलिए किया है क्योंकि आपको मैं डिस्क्राइब जो कर रही हूँ, डिस्क्राइब करने में वीडियो बहुत ज़्यादा लंबी हो जा रही है. आप इसको पॉज करके नोट डाउन भी कर सकते हो अपने नोट्स में. आगे के जो क्वेश्चंस मैं बताऊंगी वो आपको नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस है इंग्लिश लिटरेचर से रिलेटेड. लेट्स मूव ऑन क्वेश्चन नंबर 15 एंड द क्वेश्चन इज विच पोएट वॉज इन्वाइटेड बाई जॉन एफ कैनेडी टू हिज इनॉग्रेशन सेरेमनी. Answer is Robert Frost. Robert Frost was the American poet and John F. Kennedy was the president of USA at that time, and he invited that American poet who had written Stopping by Woods. Robert Frost was very famous for his book poem which is known as Stopping by Woods. Next question we have, who used the expression an aging monuments of intellect? Answer is W.B. Yeats. W.B. Yeats had expressed this view and he used this expression in his poem Selling to Byzantium. Question number 17 we have, who said about poetry emotion recollected in tranquility? Answer is Wordsworth. William Wordsworth was the romantic poet and he had given his views on poetry through this lines, and this is very famous line, then emotions recollected in tranquility. Question number 18 we have, Oedipus complex is expressed most strongly in. Answer is Sons and Lovers. This is the novel, name of the novel by D.H. Lawrence, and he had written it in 1913. Oedipus complex was a term in which a son has a very close relationship with her mother. That's why Sons and Lovers is a novel and written by D.H. Lawrence. Question number 19 we have, who wrote the maximum number of sonnets? Answer is William Wordsworth. Yes, he had written total number of sonnets, that is 523. Number 20, and this is the last question of the video, who wrote the Cries of the Children, which was published in 1841? Answer is Elizabeth Barrett Browning. Elizabeth Barrett Browning was the poetess of this poem, The Cries of the Children. So friends, this was all we had in today's video. And thank you very much for watching this. I will upload the next part of the video. Thanks a lot.